These kids have been the victims of turmoil and abuse, and now you're telling them they have to fight over who gets the sofa tonight. It's just not right. We have to do better than that.
A group called Arizona Helping Hands has been giving beds to foster families since 2013, and the organization continues to grow.
Last year, they gave out 3,000 beds. As 3TV's Lindsay Reiser explains, they're starting a new chapter now in a better location to help more people.
There's chicken.
Melissa Tracy and her family have fostered 19 children over the past 4 years.
Having the opportunity to love kids and be there for kids in like their hardest days and moments is an honor.
But she admits becoming a foster parent can be daunting.
You need beds, you need sippy cups, you need diapers, you need wipes.
She turned to Arizona Helping Hands, a nonprofit that provides those necessities for free.
Something like Arizona Helping Hands is something that it's a way that everybody can get involved in.
Now, Helping Hands is expanding and moving to North Phoenix from Scottsdale.
We can put our racking up higher, we can store more goods, we can make better use of the floor space.
Their old Scottsdale location was about the size of this quadrant, only 8,000 square feet. The new location more than doubles that, 18,000 square feet, all to hold donations and more.
We're going to build in here a really cool children's play area.
Dan Schufeld with Arizona Helping Hands says they no longer have to turn away big donations because they have no room to store them. There's still a need. DCS caseworkers took in 4,400 abuse and neglect reports in April, the highest month so far in 2018. And nearly 15,000 under the age of 21 are either in foster or group homes.
The core issues are still there, the problems with drug abuse and child abuse and other things that happen in our community.
They do hope to have more partners for this project, but they hope to open by September. In Phoenix, Lindsay Reiser for Arizona's Family.